Today we are going to speak on remedy reaction, and Kent's observations are one and the same as Robert's remedy reactions. Dr. J.T. Kent has described it as observing the actions of the remedy on the sick, while Dr. H.A. Roberts has explained it as the action of the remedy on the patient after the administration of the remedy. One of the first things required of a homeopathic physician is that his powers of observation should be highly developed. His powers of discrimination should be very keenly attuned, first that he may observe the patient in the analysis of the symptoms and selection of the remedy, and secondly that he may have the keen perception of symptoms after the remedy has been carefully selected and administered of the simile. Some action should result what is expected after the remedy has been administered, and this is what is remedy reaction. After the administration of the remedies, the commonest things that the remedies do is aggravate or ameliorate. The aggravation is of two kinds. There may be an aggravation of the disease, in which condition the patient worsens, or there may be an aggravation of symptoms, but the patient says, I feel better. An aggravation of disease means that the patient is growing weaker, the symptoms are growing stronger. But in the homeopathic aggravation, there is aggravation of symptoms of the patient while the patient is growing better. This is something which is observed by an intelligent physician after a true homeopathic prescription. Of the 12 observations of Kent, the 9th observation is the action of the medicine on healthy human beings, which means drug proving. Therefore, there are 11 observations on sick persons. Now, what is the first observation of Kent? A prolonged aggravation and final decline of the patient, what we commonly known as killer's aggravation. It means that the medicine may or may not have been correct one, but surely the potency was very, very high, and the medicine was a deep acting antisoric. Therefore, instead of helping, it has established destruction, since there has been enough irreversible tissue damage. The duty of the physician now is it necessitates immediate antidoting. After re-case-taking, a more similar medicine in low potency is to be prescribed. High potency should never be used in chronic, doubtful and pathological conditions. According to Dr. M. L. Tyler, begin with 12 or 30, especially where tissue changes may have occurred. According to Dr. H. A. Roberts, it is probably wiser not to use an antisoric in conditions. Prognosis is very bad. Second observation, there is a prolonged aggravation and then there is a very slow improvement. What does it mean? Had the case come a bit later, it would also have felt the same fate as the first observation. The medicine was right, the potency was very high. There have been enough tissue changes, the dose would act for a very long period. What is the duty of the physician now? The action of the medicine is not to be disturbed till the dose has worn off. Prognosis favorable. Third observation. The aggravation is quick, short and strong with rapid improvement of the patient. The reaction of the economy is vigorous. There is no much tissue changes or very superficial if any. The potency was a bit higher. An aggravation of this kind is very much reassuring. Medicinal action is not to be disturbed. Very good prognosis. The fourth observation is recovery without any aggravation whatsoever. It is the most similar medicine. The potency exactly fitted the case. There is no tissue change. There is only a functional disorder. What is the duty of the physician? This is the highest ideal of cure in the acute disease condition. Prognosis is very, very good. Fifth observation, amelioration comes first and then comes aggravation. Now this is a little dicey. The medicine was antipathic in nature, or it was only partially or superficially similar. The duty of the physician is a more similar medicine is to be given after re-casting. The prognosis is bad here. The sixth observation, too short relief of symptoms. In acute disease, the medicine has to be repeated much oftener. The infection being violent or virulent in nature, in chronic disease, the medicine was partially similar. There is a condition which interferes with the action of remedy. Structural changes have occurred or organs are destroyed. What is the duty of the physician? In acute disease, a more similar medicine is to be found out and to be given frequently. And in chronic disease, a medicine has to be given, which has to be given infrequently. Prognosis again too bad in chronic disease. Seventh observation, a full amelioration of symptoms, yet no special relief to patient. Now these are latent conditions, especially organic pathologies in such patients that prevent improvement beyond certain limit. A patient with one kidney or a bigger part of the lungs destroyed can only be relieved. So what we can do is only palliation. The patient is curable to a certain degree. If there is some deterioration of important viscous, complete cure is not possible. The prognosis is bad. What is the 8th observation? Some patients prove every remedy they take. This is what is called idiosyncratic of the hypersensitive patients. He is inclined to be hypersensitive to all the things. He has idiosyncrasy to be affected by everything. He is often incurable. What is the duty of the physician? He has to be given lowest, rather crude potencies of the indicated remedy, even mother tinctures, both in acute as well as chronic disease. But remember, he is the most useful patient for proving. Nevertheless, such constitutions are improved by such drugs such as nitric acid and the prognosis is bad. 9th observation, action of the medicines upon the provers. What does it mean? Healthy prover is always benefited by proving if they are properly conducted. It is well to observe carefully the constitutional states of an individual about to become a prover. Master Hahnemann in his Organon from 105 to 145 has given instructions regarding drug provings. The prognosis is favorable. What is the 10th observation? New symptoms appearing after the remedy. Now the inference is that the medicine is wrong. Greater the number of symptoms, more wrong is the medicine. What is the duty of the physician in such condition? If the symptoms are of light nature, we should wait till the new symptoms pass off, or after re-case taking, a more similar medicine has to be given. But if symptoms are of serious nature and threatening to life, it has to be antidoted. The prognosis is again bad. 11th observation. Old symptoms are observed and reappear. Now, this means that the medicine which the physician has given has been absolutely right. More such old symptoms reappear, more the chronic disease is curable. What is the duty of the physician? The action of medicine should not be disturbed. If re-established symptoms, discharge, eruptions stay for a pretty long time, the medicine may be repeated. Here, the old symptoms, diseases may come and go in reverse order of appearance. The prognosis is very good. Lastly, the 12th observation, the symptoms taking the wrong direction. The medicine has been the wrong one. Example, rheumatism of the extremities disappear and the heart becomes involved. What is the duty of the physician? The medicine is to be antidoted at once. A more similar remedy has to be found out after re-case taking and administered. The prognosis is quite unfavorable. So that finishes our remedy reaction for the day, guys. Thank you very much from Homeopathic Health Solutions and Dr. Samir. Thank you very much.